Hello, dear friends. I give news from the Matrix to report what is happening in the world supposedly, because nobody knows the secret operations. But from time to time, I feel the need to get out of the Matrix so as not to get overwhelmed and go into metaphysical subjects, because I am a mystic, hermit, ascetic and alchemist. Above my profession as a journalist, which is part of my life mission, but which sometimes overwhelms me. Opinion piece. Decoding the Matrix. Consciousness creates reality. Everyone sees what he wants to see. The observer creates the observer. Excuse me. The observer creates the observed. Creates a structure of space and time. The universe is a mental construct. The ultimate truth is of all is emptiness. Form is emptiness and emptiness is form. The cosmos is immaterial, mental and spiritual. All things lack intrinsic reality. Matter proceeds from a primary substance. Let's start. There is no such thing as a neutral observation, because the observer creates and modifies what is observed according to quantum physics. At a quantum level, factors associated with consciousness are known to change the behavior of matter, such as photons, suggesting that matter itself may be a thing that is consciously perceived. This principle demolishes the hypothesis of supposed objectivity on which official science is based, since everything would have a subjective basis, and everyone sees what he wants to see. It's very difficult to understand this principle because we operate from the unconscious. If I want to create one thing, I get the opposite. It is because of sabotage from my own unconscious, and only those who have done internal work manage to overcome this contradiction. It is also true that creating things in this dense world requires not only mental concentration, but also a lot of hard work. We, the observers, human beings like you and me, are responsible for how consciousness is transformed into physical matter. Besides, it is possible to get anywhere if you don't trust yourself, and most people don't trust themselves and don't bother to develop the confidence that leads to success. The honey of triumph is only available to the bold, not to the timid or the pusillanimous. That is why to succeed in life, in any field, we must first conquer ourselves. New physics. Consciousness creates reality, a statement that has gained much attention throughout various alternative media around the world. Consciousness has been studied by numerous scientists, especially in its relation to quantum physics, and how it might be correlated with the nature of our reality. What is consciousness? Consciousness includes a number of things. It's how we perceive our world, our thoughts, being conscious, our intention, and much more, according to Arjun Walia. A fundamental conclusion of the new physics recognizes that the observer creates reality. As observers, we are personally involved with the creation of our own reality. Physicists are forced to admit that the universe is a mental construct. Pioneering physicist Sir James Jeans wrote, in quotes, "The stream of knowledge is moving towards a non-mechanical reality. The universe begins to look more like a great thought than a great machine. Mind no longer seems to be an accident intruder into the realm of matter. We should rather celebrate it as the creator and governor of the realm of matter. Accept that indisputable conclusion. The universe is immaterial, mental, and spiritual. Study. A study written by Robert Lanza suggests that observers are responsible for determining physical reality, and that conscious observers themselves generate and create the structures of time and space. All of this in quotes. Where does the physical world come from? Matter is the smallest observable form. Atoms appear and disappear all the time. The idea that physical matter arises from a non-physical realm, such as the quantum vacuum or something else unknown to us, is not new. Nikola Tesla himself believed that all perceptible matter proceeds from a primary substance or something tenuous beyond conception, filling all space, the akasha or luminiferous ether, upon which acts the life-giving prana or creative force, calling into existence in endless cycles of all things and phenomena. Within a century, it will be well known that the vacuum of space that fills the universe is itself the real substrate of the universe. The vacuum is a circulating state. The vacuum in a circulating state becomes matter. The electron is the fundamental particle of matter, and is a vacuum vortex with a vacuum without a vacuum at the center, and is dynamically stable. The speed of light relative to the vacuum is the maximum speed that nature has provided, and it is an inherent property of the vacuum. The vacuum is a subtle fluid and known in material media. The vacuum is massless, continuous, non-viscous, and incompressible, and it is responsible for all properties of matter, and that vacuum has always existed and will exist forever. This non-physical field could also be dark energy. We do not understand why it exists or how it is created. We simply know that it provides an ever-present force in the space-time which causes the universe to expand. In fact, recent high-precision experimental observations indicate that dark energy could be a cosmological vacuum energy. Concept of vacuity. Vacuity is not nothingness but an inherent lack of existence. Sunyata, often translated as emptiness or voidness, is a Buddhist concept that has multiple meanings. It can refer to an ontological understanding of reality, a meditative state, or a phenomenological analysis of experience. Emptiness is an essential term in the Buddhist tradition. When emptiness is said, it refers to the absence of something. For example, I would be empty of a permanent or solid entity. It is to say something that would appear to be there, such as a solid self. What are things empty of? In practical terms, we can say that they are empty of that to which your mind clings. For the mind to cling to something, it would seem that there should be something solid, so it can latch on. The Buddhist tradition says that this sense of inherent existence, which is what the mind uses to attach itself to something, is that which is not there. That which doesn't really exist, that is, that which presents itself as permanent, independent, and unitary. When we speak of emptiness, what we are saying is not, of course, that things doesn't exist. That we are saying is that there is an exaggeration, a projection that is being made, and that is what doesn't exist. The ultimate truth is emptiness. Emptiness is not nothingness, but inherent non-existence. The self-grasping mind erroneously projects inherent existence onto phenomena. All phenomena appear to your mind as if they exist independently and without realizing that his appearance is misleading. We instinctively assent to it and apprehend all phenomena as if they exist inherently and truly. This is the main reason why we are trapped in samsara or illusion, according to Ngese Kelsang Gyatso. Emptiness is a mode of perception, a way of looking at experience. It neither adds anything to nor takes anything away from the data of physical and mental events. You look at the events in the mind and senses without thinking about whether there is anything behind them. This mode is called emptiness because it is empty of the presuppositions we usually add to experience to make sense of it. The stories and worldviews we design to explain who we are and the world we live in. Emptiness, or sunyata, is a key theme in the Heart Sutra, which is commonly recited by Buddhists around the world. The sutra states that the skandhas, or physical tendencies of the body, which constitute our mental and physical existence, are empty in their nature or essence. That is, empty of any nature or essence. But he also states that this emptiness is equal to form, denoting fullness. In other words, that this is an emptiness that at the same time is no different from the kind of reality we normally attribute to events. It's not a nihilistic emptiness that undermines our world, but a positive emptiness that defines it. Excuse me. Emptiness doesn't mean nothingness, but rather that all things lack intrinsic reality, intrinsic objectivity, intrinsic identity, or intrinsic reference. Lacking such a static essence of substance, it doesn't make them non-existent, but makes them totally relative. This relativity of all phenomena is opposed to materialism, to the notion that phenomena exist in their own right, by themselves. Thus, the Buddha's philosophy is seen as the middle way between nihilism and materialism. In Eastern thought, emptiness is not a concept that expresses a gloomy, melancholic, or pessimistic view of life. On the contrary, for Buddhists, emptiness is the condition of possibility of manifestation of all entities and of becoming. Hence, the statement in the Heart Sutra that form is emptiness and emptiness is form. Indeed, thanks to emptiness, there is room for movement and the continuity of being is broken, an interruption that introduces the multiplicity of entities within reality. And that's all for today. Thanks a lot, dear friends, for your attention.